Paula, une fois de plus, bienvenue dans cette édition
Thanks for choosing the morning call on Africa News.
Je vous le disais en titre, le président
President Salva Kiir of South Sudan has accused dark forces of seeking to destroy the country as the army celebrates its 34th anniversary amid tensions.
L'armée à Juba. Ces manifestations interviennent quelque temps après l'annonce d'une restructuration de la
The manifestations come at a time when the restructuring of the army has been announced with the creation of a defense council and the splitting of the army into three branches, the Air Force, the Marine, and the Infantry. The army's image has been tainted since the start of the Civil War, as well as the recent resignations of senior army officials.
Well, political analysts believe that this could be a positive step as President Salva Kiir is trying to restore the public's trust in the army, whose reputation has suffered since the fresh wave of fighting erupted in Juba in July 2016. The United Nations and several rights groups have accused the army of mass killings, rape, the burning of villages, and even looting. Local media have reported that President Kiir's decree also changed the name of the army from SPLA, that is Sudan People's Liberation Army, to the SSDF, South Sudan Defense Forces. The press secretary to the president, Ateny Wek Ateny, has however insisted that part of the decree had been misunderstood, saying the real thing is that the SPLA still remains SPLA. This latest reshuffle was done to fit the structure of the army following the recent appointment of the new army chief general, James Ajongo. President Salva Kiir also used the occasion of commemorating the SPLA army to deny claims that there was a trend of military recruitment predominantly among certain ethnic groups in the country, accusing what he termed as the forces of evil trying to destroy South Sudan. Our correspondent in South Sudan, Deng Machol, joins us now to talk about President Salva Kiir's latest round of actions. Good morning, Deng. The president is saying there is no form of ethnic discrimination in the army, yet we have seen top military officials quitting the army on the same claim.
Yeah, well, this is the tough question, but in other way, you can agree or disagree with the president's key claim. When the fighting broke out in 2013 in Juba, the army has divided along a thick line. Majority of the soldiers, one is former Vice President Dr. Riek Machar, and the Dinka soldiers remain with Priski. That means the present army is purely make up of Dinka and few from minority tribes. Though the president tried to downplay last year's thing that he has been forced to rely on soldiers from his Dinka ethnic group. That is not true. Despite the president's defend mechanism, you can conclude that there is a bias in arm as dominated by one tribe. Therefore, the president administration should put a dynamic force that can recruit all the tribes in the army to become national army.
And Deng, President Salva Kiir called the rebels evil forces and urged the South Sudanese people not to allow external forces to drive the country further into chaos. He seems to be putting the blame at their doorstep. To what or who exactly was he referring to?
Perhaps the president is indeed referring this to his former vice president, Dr. Riek Machar, who is part in South Africa, and as well as members of former detainees, who he always described them as traitors, betrayers, and power gradients. No doubt about that. Residents fear that these are politicians who tie his seats, and he says they fail to get rid of him, so they are lobbying for external intervention in South Sudan.
And finally, Deng, on the supposed change of name of the National Army, there seems to be some confusion there. Has it been changed or not?
Yeah, in fact, there seem to be confusions. Although the office of the president clarified that the name of the SPLA has not been changed, to that of South Sudan Defense Force. They say the new title of SLA Chief of General Staff still assigned to the SLA and not South Sudan Defense Force, which is controversial. Yes, the president shall order on restructuring of the leadership of the SPLA, which named the Chief of Defense Force, but not SPLA, and followed by duties. That seems the president has to block his order.